Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Friends, today we're going to learn a new topic that's called dividend per share formula. We are going to learn the formula, the interpretation part, and also with an example. So let's get into the nitty-gritty of the same. The dividend per share formula is basically the annual dividend which the company that pays divided by the purchase price of the share. So let's understand this formula. Now, before an investor, it calculates the dividend yield. Okay, this is a new word. Dividend yield is basically the percentage. The stock he or she needs to know, the dividend per share, which he or she calls as DPS. That's the dividend per share, right? So the dividend, again, I'll just write for you over here so that we don't have problem. The dividend per share formula is equal to your annual dividend divided by the number of shares. So since the calculation is done after the dividend is being paid, an investor will only get to know the past records. Now, for example, if an investor wants to know the DPS of the company, he will have to look at the data of the latest year and also the following year. So let's start understanding this formula with the help of an example. Let's take a practical example to illustrate the dividend per share formula. Let's say there is a company called Honeybee Company that they have paid an annual dividend as $20,000. The beginning outstanding stock was let's say $4,000, and the ending stock, which was standing at $7,000. So what we need to calculate over here is the dividend per share of Honeybee Company. In this example, we can go for a simple average to find out the average outstanding shares. The beginning outstanding stock was 4,000 and the ending was 7,000. So average will be divided by 2. It's going to be 5,500. Over here, we have used a simple average, and this is our final answer. The annual dividend that was been paid was 20,000. So we'll get the number here. We'll pull down the number here. And finally, using the DPS formula, we get DPS formula is equal to your annual dividend divided by the number of shares, which is going to be is equal to 20,000 divided by 5,500, or you can take directly the numbers from here. It's 3.64 per share. So now if we want to find out the dividend yield of the company, we can do so. We need to just keep in mind that a lower dividend per share, a DPS, does not mean that the company has no growth potential. We need to know that dividend yield and other financial measures to ensure whether the company has enough growth potential or not. Let's understand the explanation part of the dividend per share formula. Now, in this formula, the dividend per share, the most important part is the number of shares. You can simply take the record of the beginning shares, and you can take the record of the ending shares and calculate the simple average outstanding shares, or else you can also go for the weighted average. You can go for the weighted average of the number of shares. So in dividend per shares, we take what annual dividend, and in the case of the EPS, earning per share, we use the net income. This is for DPS, we take annual dividend. So the use of the weighted average method is true for those companies. The weighted average method, VAM method, is used for those basically the companies that have paid the dividend for the existing shares, like in January, and issues new shares in December. So you can get an idea depending upon the approach, the company, and we may choose to calculate the method. Now, what is exactly the use of this particular formula? See, any investor would look at different stocks to find out in which he should or invest in. Now, for that, investor looks at different ratios. Now, only DPS may not provide overall outlook for the company, but if an investor can look at the other financial ratios along with the dividend payout ratio, like you can say the dividend yield and DPS, he or she would have a solid understanding of the company. Now, if an investor sees that the dividend payout ratio of the company is, if it is lower, that means that basically means that the company is it's reinvesting more to increase the value of the company. Now, before an investor ever decides to invest, he or she needs to look at all the measures to find out the holistic view of the financial affairs. Now, this is the graph that I wanted to show you for the three companies that have been taken. This is just a practical example that has been taken to make you understand that what exactly company do in real life. There's this company called Colgate. Colgate dividend per share, as you can see, right from 2008 or 9 onwards till 2016, it has continuously increased its dividend payout ratio. It started from 0.5, that was just $0.5 per share. Then it moved on to, you can say, at least around 1.59 or 1.6 to 1.6 per share. That's a continuous increase, but at a reducing way. It's not a complete rise in the dividend. But if we see in terms of Amazon and Google, they don't pay dividend at all. So that means there can be only two situations. Either the company is really doing bad, they have complete bad losses, or the company is plowing back its funds or the amount of the funds that they have earned, they are not paying at all, and they are reinvesting in the company's assets or for investments which the company may do in the future course. So Amazon and Google, such type of companies are not paying it. That means their plowback is 100% and the dividend payout ratio is 0%. There's a company called Jet Airways. They are not actually paying the dividends because they have negative earnings. But some companies, if they really want to pay the dividend in spite of the negative earnings, then they have to follow some rules and regulation, you know, and some of the criteria for the same is like, you know, you can pay the dividend only after paying the dividend for the past years if that has been outstanding, and you can pay only the average dividend, the average percentage of the last 3 years from your reserves itself. Now, this is basically the calculator for the dividend per share. You can put some numbers over here. Annual dividend, let's say they are paying 20,000, let's say $200 per share. Let's say 2 million is the total amount they are paying as dividend. Okay, 2 million. And they have total 1 million in their shares. Have I increased one more number here? So that means 2 per share. So as the dividend is going to reduce, the dividend per share is going to reduce because the number of shares are going to be same. If there is an increase, then the amount can change over here. So what you can do, you can do some permutation and combination, come out with some really good conclusion that where exactly goes the direct relationship and where exactly it goes the inverse relationship. I hope you have got a really great insight regarding the dividend per share formula, and thank you everyone. Cheers.